Hello children, this is your third part of your lesson biological classification. So with this video we are going to complete the unit. So in this video you will be seeing about kingdom fungi, plantae and animalia, and about virus, viroids and lichens. So all these things we are going to discuss now. So let us start the class. The fungi, it is a eukaryotic cell. So the cell organelles are well developed, but they lack chlorophyll, achlorophyllous, and they depend on other organisms, heterotrophic. And these fungi have small spores. So they are spore bearing and non-vascular, that is xylem and phloem are absent in them. So they are non-vascular organisms. Fungi are eukaryotic, achlorophyllous, heterotrophic, spore-bearing, non-vascular organisms. So the cell wall of the fungus, it is made up of chitin, a material called chitin. And the body of the fungus, it will be usually very long and slender. It will be very long and very thin, not very too much of hard. It is long and slender, thread-like structures called hyphae is present. And a group of hyphae, it is known as mycelium. A network of hyphae, it is known as mycelium. And usually fungi are symbionts. So symbionts means they will live with the support of another organism. So it is like parasite only, but it does not take up all the nutrition of the host plant or host animal. What it does is it just gets attached to the host, and it helps the host to get nutrition, and that also gets nutrition. So a mutual relationship. So fungi lives in such a way, that is symbionts means an association with algae called lichens and with roots of higher plants called mycorrhiza. So what this fungi does, they will associate and live with algae. So they are called as lichens. And sometimes they may live on very huge plants. So huge category plants. So in such plants, these fungi will go get attached. So in such cases, they are called as mycorrhiza. So see the fungal cell wall. It is, as I told you, the cell wall is present of chitin and glucans is there. And below the chitin only, the cell wall membrane is present. And in the cell membrane, the membrane proteins are present. On above the chitin, mannoproteins are present. So this, like this only, the fungal cell wall will be. So this is the structure of the fungi. We were talking about hyphae. A long slender structure will be there. So on the left side, you can see the fungal hyphae. And inside it, some algal cells are there. And below and on the top part, the fungal hyphae is there. In between, the algal cells is there. So this is only called as symbionts. They are together, present together, and they live together. A mutual relationship is there between the fungi and the algae. And on the right side, if you see, means the mycorrhiza is there. So in higher plants, on the roots, these fungi will be present for some mutual relationship. So because of the chlorophyll present in them, or because of some chemicals present in them, they help in food production. So with mycorrhiza, if you can see the image, without the mycorrhiza, see how the plant becomes. So this is one example. These are the two symbionts made by the fungus. So symbionts are also helpful. They are not like parasites. They are helpful and they maintain a mutual relationship. Next is classification of fungi. So these are classified into phycomycetes, that is lower fungi. It is also called as lower fungi.
and example Rhizopus, and Ascomycetes, it is also known as sac fungi, example Neurospora, and Basidiomycetes, it is also known as club fungi, example Agaricus, and Deuteromycetes, also known as fungi imperfect, example Fusarium. So these are the four major categories of the fungi. Phycomycetes, these members of Phycomycetes, they are usually present on the aquatic habitats. So they are usually present in water, and on some, you can find some wood pieces which are always wet and they are decaying in those damp places where decaying woods are there. On the those places also these Phycomycetes may be found, or they may be some obligate parasites in the plants also. Sometimes Phycomycetes may be parasites also. The mycelium is aseptate, that is, they don't have any separation of walls in between them, and they are cenocytic. So for example Rhizopus. So cenocytic is nothing but the hyphae is present. So usually fungi will have hyphae, long slender like structures, and there is no separation of septae. Aseptate means there is no separation, and they are called cenocytic. So when separation is not there, when septate is not there, it is called as cenocytic. And next is Ascomycetes. So they are commonly, Ascomycetes are commonly known as sac fungi. And the Ascomycetes, they are mostly multicellular, example Penicillium, and sometimes unicellular, example yeast. So these are all Ascomycetes. So these example Penicillium and yeast and all are very familiar words that you have already heard. So now you must know that these are all belong to Ascomycetes group, and they are saprophytic, that is, they feed on dead and decayed matters. So they are decomposers, and sometimes they are parasitic also. They are growing on the dung, that is the waste, excretory waste of the cow or buffalo. And mycelium, it is branched and septated. So they have separation, they have septate called the separation, and it is branched. Example, Neurospora. So Neurospora, it is mostly used in biochemical and genetic research. So for all these purposes, these Neurospora is used. Next is Basidiomycetes. So it is Basidiomycetes. It's commonly all the mushrooms, the bracket fungi or puff balls. So these are all coming under Basidiomycetes. So these Basidiomycetes, they grow in soil, in huge logs, tree logs, and in tree stumps, the branch, the main trunk of it. So all these places, the living plant body also, sometimes as parasites also, they live. So example, rust and smuts. So these are the examples of Basidiomycetes. And the here also the mycelium is branched and septate. And next is Deuteromycetes. So these Deuteromycetes are commonly called as imperfect fungi, because only the vegetative phase of these fungi are known. The mycelium, it is here also, it is septate and branched, and some members are saprophytes and parasites. So they may feed on dead and decayed matter or the living cell. So while a large number, most of them are usually decomposers of litter on waste products, where the waste products are there. So in those places only these new Deuteromycetes will be present, and they will feed on those waste products. So they help in mineral cycling, example Alternaria. So these are all the examples of Deuteromycetes. So why it is called as fungi imperfect is, the vegetative phase, like when it will grow and get mature, that phase is always unknown in the deuteromycetes. So that is why it is called as a fungi imperfect. The duration period of growth is usually unpredictable. So it's called as an fungi imperfect. So these are all the different types of fungi that we saw in the classification of fungi. So penicillium, yeast, puffballs, bracket fungi, and alternaria. So these are the different types of fungi. So for you to see the images, I have put up on this slide. Next is kingdom plantae. So under this kingdom plantae, all the plants are placed under kingdom plantae. So as you can see in the image, algae, different some higher algae like rhodophyte, phaeophyte, and chlorophyta. So these are all the higher algae which are put under the kingdom plantae, and bryophytes, mosses, tracheophytes, all the ferns and gymnosperms, all the conifers and angiosperms, all the flowering plants, all these are put under kingdom plantae. So this kingdom plantae, it includes all the eukaryotic chlorophylls, so presence of chlorophyll and photosynthetic multicellular organisms. Only a few of them are heterotrophic, that is, they are insectivorous plants or parasites. So insectivorous means for nitrogen supply and all, they need to capture all the insects for nutrition. So those such plants are called as insectivorous. So the insectivorous plants are sometimes heterotrophic, and some are also parasites in the kingdom plantae. And the cell level, if you see, means they are eukaryotic. That is, the cell organelles are well developed with cellulosic. The cell wall is made up of cellulose, and it is present everywhere. It is cosmopolitan in occurrence, and economically also, if you see, means it is very important because they produce plants produce food fodder. That is, food for the animals. They give timber, fuel, etc. So all these are uses of plants. So it is economically also, they are very important. And this kingdom plantae, they consist of algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperms, and angiosperms. According to the biogeography, if you see, it means a type said to be cosmopolitan distribution. If its range extends almost across all and most of the world in appropriate habitats. So such taxon, that is, the such categories are called to be cosmopolitanism or cosmopolitism. So for denoting how the plants are being distributed, they have given this text so that you should know that plants are present everywhere. So that is why it's called as cosmopolitan in occurrence. And the last kingdom is kingdom Animalia. So this kingdom Animalia, it consists of heterotrophic. So heterotrophic means, already know, it depends on other organisms for nutrition. So it is heterotrophic eukaryotic multicellular organisms are coming under the kingdom Animalia. So here the cell wall is absent, and the chlorophyll is also absent. And these Animalia members, they show holozoic nutrition. They depend on the plants directly or also indirectly. And sometimes these Animalia may be saprophytic, parasitic, or symbiont. So I don't have to explain each and every term. You already know, I have already explained you about all these terms. And they digest their food inside an internal cavity, and the food they eat is stored as glycogen or fat. So we have completed all the kingdoms of five kingdom in five kingdom classification. Next is we are moving on to virus, viroids and lichens. So what is a virus? Virus, it is a nucleoprotein entity. So a protein is present inside it. So based on that only, the whole being is there. And it has the ability to utilize the synthetic machinery of a living cell. That is, if it is near any living cell, it has the ability to manipulate that cell of another organism for the virus to multiply. They can use up the other living cells for multiplication. So such an ability is given to the virus. So a virus consists of two parts. It is of two parts, nucleoid and capsid. So the nucleoid, it is the infective part. So because of nucleoid only, the virus is very infective and it causes some metabolic changes to the host cell. And capsid is only the protein covering, that is, it is the genetic material with some protein subunits are present inside the capsid, known as capsomers, and antigenic properties are also present. And the envelope, it is the outer loose covering present in some animal viruses and rarely present in plant and bacterial viruses. So this covering envelope is made up of protein, lipids and carbohydrates. So, if the virus is without envelope, it is called as a naked virus. So, this is the viral structure, different viral structure. So, we have three different viruses, bacteriophage, tobacco mosaic virus, TMV, and human immunodeficiency virus, HIV. So, in bacteriophage, if you see, means the capsid protein sheath is there. Inside, DNA is present and these are the structures of bacteriophage. And here in tobacco mosaic virus, if you see, means inside the protein sheath, the RNA is present. That is the genetic material, and on the outer covering, the protein is being enveloped. And human immunodeficiency virus, if you see, means a protein, envelope protein is there. The envelope is present above it. Inside you can see capsid and enzymes are present and the RNA, the genetic material are present. So these are the structures, different structures of the virus. The second topic is viroids. So these viroids, it is the smallest self-replicating. That is, it does not need any help for replication, for division of particles. And it is described by Diner in 1971. And these viroids, they have very infectious RNA particles. And it does not have any protein coat. These viroids are obligate parasites. So these are parasites which live on the living host cell. And the last topic is lichens. So these lichens, it is a composite organism. It has a composition of the fungus living in some intimate association, in a close relationship with one or more photosynthetic partners. It may be green algae or cyanobacterium. So lichens is nothing but an association of fungus with a photosynthetic partner. It may be algae or cyanobacterium. The fungal member of this lichen is called as mycobiont. And the photosynthetic partner is known as the photobiont. And the lichens are considered to be the pioneer organisms because they make a region suitable for other plants also. So on some withering, in withering rocks or accumulation of organic debris, so, a decrease in lichen population indicates that the air pollution is high. So, even though they symbiont, that is, they create a very close relationship not only to make their survival, but also they help to develop the purity, that is develop the quality standard of the environment. So if any pollution is there, it accumulates and turns them into nutrition. So that is the role of lichens. So if there is a decrease in the population of lichens, then we can tell that the population, air pollution has been increased. So now we have come to the last slide of the PPT and end of the session. So this is the second part of your unit 1 lesson. So you have come across many new topics and new words. I know it is very totally confusing, but you have to learn. Just go by part by part, because it is a video, since you can rewrite and see. So if you cannot understand it, watch it again and again so that you clearly get what I am trying to tell. If you have still doubts, there is no problem. If we have any Zoom class by chance, I am there to clear all your doubts. So learn well this unit. We have completed unit 1. So this is all about biological classification. And a PDF will be presented to you in your groups, WhatsApp groups. So copy all the answers in your notebooks, even detailed answers also. You have to write it in your note. And when we are asked for submission, please submit it. And get your corrections. So do well, children. Learn. Take care of yourself. Thank you.